What's up guys, in this video I'm going to show you what's inside an RC helicopter. I mean a proper RC helicopter. Or do you want me to show you the toy ones? I think this is a better idea. By the way, they don't match the definitions of the helicopters, so let's see a real RC helicopter. Here we go. What is what in an RC helicopter? The first is the receiver. The receiver gets the signal from the transmitter. This receiver interprets the transmitter signal to instruct the different devices in the helicopter. For example, the flybar controller. This controller instructs the servos how to move and how to move the swash plate itself, which controls the pitch of the blades. Also, the receiver instructs the ESC. ESC stands for electric speed controller. The main rotor is directly connected to the tail rotor. They are spinning together. The helicopter is controlled by the pitches of the blades only. The rotation speed, I mean the RPM, is constant on a helicopter. This ESC has an integrated BEC, a battery elimination circuit. This is required because these batteries are very big in terms of the voltage, but the servos can run up to 7 volts, I don't remember. Technically, the ESC is configurable, so it can provide 5, 6, 7, 8 volts, depending on the components of the helicopter, what they can use. Higher voltage is lower current draw, which means better performance in general, but obviously not all the components can operate on the same voltage, so that's why there is a compromise somewhere. In some cases, the helicopter is using a combustion engine, like this. This is a nitromethane engine, but this engine can be even a petrol or gas engine in the US, or even jet turbine, a jet engine, which is a smaller version of the real jet engines. And to be honest, not just scale helicopters are using the jet engine, even performance 3D helicopters like this can have it, but it's not so cheap, so if you crash the helicopter, that can be very painful. So basically, this is how a helicopter looks inside. As you see, the motor rotates the main gear here, which can spin the blades. There is another gear. This is called auto-rotation gear, because this can spin forward independently from the main gear. So that's why even with motor switched off, the blades can spin, but this auto-rotation gear rotates the tail as well. There are more versions how the tail connected to the main blades. In this helicopter, this is a torque tube, so there are gears, there are gears. There is a fourth servo here. This is moving the tail blades. And here are the batteries. Let's see how this is working. So, as you see, the receiver receives the signal, which is forwarded to the flybarless controller, and the flybarless controller is instructing the servos to move in various positions. And this is how the helicopter flies. This is happening to the tail as well. And pretty much that's it. In some cases, like on this helicopter, there are a few differences. But the basic concept is exactly the same. As you see, motor, receiver, and flybarless controller, because they are integrated here. ESC, battery, servos, exactly the same. There are two differences. First, this is a receiver and flybarless control integrated together, a Mikado V-bar Neo. Exactly the same function. Servos are moving the splash plates, splash plate sets the pitch of the blades, and pretty much that's it. Another difference, as you see, there is only one main gear and no auto-rotation gear, because this helicopter is belt-driven. So the tail connected to the main rotor through a belt. In this case, the ESC and the BEC are integrated into this housing again. But on a nitromethane helicopter, a combustion engine helicopter, this is not possible because there is no ESC. There is BEC only, which supplies the electricity for all the electric components. Obviously, the motor is not electric, so it's not required. In that case, the engine has a fifth servo, which can operate this arm. And this is how the engine throttle is controlled. This machine is old, very old, compared to an RC helicopter. This is a T-Rex 500 CF, the first version of the airline T-Rex 500 series. But this is the 500, which is belt driven. Since then, airline is using torque tube only in this size. How the helicopter is operating is almost the same. There is one big difference. Instead of a flybarless controller, this is a gyroscope. The gyroscope can sense the yaw of the helicopter only. And this is how it controls the tail. These things, I mean the main blades, are not controlled by a flybarless controller. I'm going to show you how. They are connected to the flybar. That's why that controller is called flybarless controller, whilst this one is a flybar. If there is no flybar, you must have a flybarless controller. If there is flybar, you don't need a flybarless controller. The flybar is a bit outdated. I don't think so any serious helicopter companies are producing helicopters with flybar still. There are a million reasons why. Let's discuss it in another video. But the concept, again, is the same. Servos are moving the splash plate up and down, and the splash plate sets the pitch of the blades through the flybar. Tail servo, receiver inside, the motor, main gear, auto-rotation gear, That's it. Let's see how a flybarless controller works on a helicopter. If I move the helicopter, you can see this flash plate is moving against the leaning of the helicopter. This is how it tries to compensate this unwanted move. Why this is important and how it's working, why it's there, and so on, I will explain everything in another video. So this is an RC helicopter inside. I hope so you like this video. If so, please leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe to get notified about the newer episodes, and see you in the next one. No connection broken. H. Come on. Shut down. It's over. Great. És kiderül, hogy nem vettem fel a hangot, és akkor szimplán besírok.